Hello, welcome to Ivana's Smoshk Life. Today we will talk into more details about skilled versus unskilled jobs in Norway, and for you to better understand what is counted or what is considered as skilled job in Norway, what is considered as unskilled job in Norway, and how actually which of the strategies are better, how should you consider your immigration to Norway, and actually we will discuss whether you need it, because it couldn't be that maybe Norway is not a country for you. But we will talk about this stuff in the end of the video, in the part 2. And the first part, let's start about skilled versus unskilled jobs in Norway. Let's go! In order to answer the question about what is the difference between skilled and unskilled jobs in Norway, let's first look on the requirements from the UDI about skilled work in Norway and unskilled work in Norway, because you will need to have a visa to come to Norway, and actually it doesn't matter if you have a job offer. If you don't receive a visa from UDI, your job offer, it doesn't matter that much. So that's why you need to get a correct job offer. You need to have a right job, right documents filled in, and right information presented to the UDI to receive actually your possibility or your visa to enter the country. Let's start with the skilled worker. Of course, some of the details about more types of visas in Norway I have already presented in another video, and you can find it somewhere here, link, and watch it afterwards. But let's really talk into the details. What is expected from the skilled worker in Norway? First of all, it is expected that your job requires a high education. And actually, your higher education needs to be specific to the job you're looking for. So if let's say that you are a nurse, you need to have higher education to be able to work as a nurse. Or if you want to be a project manager, you need to have appropriate higher education to work as a project manager. You cannot have some degree in chemical engineering and then come and work as a project manager in Norway, because you will be rejected in your visa application if you do like that. Most likely. Not always, but most likely. So it's one thing. You need to have appropriate higher education. Second option that you actually could have that will tell you that this is a skilled work job and visa, it is vocational training. So for example, carpenter, health worker, not the same as nurse. So vocational training from your country that is appropriate, or like documentation received from the same institution or like appropriate institution in Norway, will be enough. So then it means higher education, vocational training, all of this counts for the skilled worker job in Norway, and then you will be able to receive a visa. But I know some of you asked me already in the comments, what about if we have a long experience practical in the work and we don't have appropriate education? Can we still come to Norway and work in the same way? The sad news I hear that it's UDI counts it as an exceptional case, which will be considered personally for each person. So there is no generic rule that if you have a long experience and maybe some courses in your work, that you will be able to come and work in Norway in the same position. So this is not, it's kind of, they need to consider it, they need to think maybe how hard it is to find the person with this for this job in Norway to be able to give you possibility to enter the country and fill in this position. So long work experience without appropriate education that needs to be a qualification for getting the job doesn't mean that you will be able to enter the country. So what I mean is, you can get a job offer, you can find employer, but when you apply for visa, this is where you can be rejected. And that's why it is so important to look into these details and understand it, that it's two entities that are not related to each other. Employer, they don't know that, like Norwegian employers, they don't know that much about rules for entering the Norway for people outside of Norway. And that's why it's your work to make sure that everything will fit together, so you do not waste time on that. So this is the major description of the skilled worker. As you understand, it's mainly about your education and that you train to perform the job you are coming to work in Norway. And this is okay. In Norway, it's like it's a country. They have their own rules. They want to have these people immigrating inside the country. So it's understandable. But when we talk about unskilled jobs in Norway, or what does it mean unskilled, like how to get the visa for that, right? What should you apply for? So I made some research and I found that actually when I talk about unskilled work in Norway, it's more common for the seasonal work. So if you want to apply for the visa, it should be seasonal worker visa. As you understand, when we talk about seasonal work, it means that it's restricted in time. So it shouldn't be for, it cannot be for the year or something. So it will be restricted to the time when the season for this job is. It could be also tourism. It could be working in the restaurant, in the hotels. But there is a but. So there is an issue. When you apply for seasonal work visa, you first of all need a full-time job offer. It can be job offer from more than one employer, where it needs to be described like really in the details, written down what will be your work tasks, what you will be doing. You need to have a minimal salary wage for Norway, so you can support yourself. You cannot take family with you, so you will come only by yourself. And if you found a job, or if you apply for visa, or like you want to apply for visa, for seasonal visa, that is not related to agriculture or forestry fields, actually your employer needs to get a specific document from the now.nav.nor, where it will be stated that they cannot find person who can do this job inside the country. That's why they want to take you on that position. As you can understand, it's very hard and it can be really challenging to find this job. But when it comes to the agriculture and forestry, here is exception. Actually, for this type of jobs, Norwegian employer doesn't need to have the supportive document from the NAV. So it should be a bit easier to get this type of job. But remember, it's seasonal. It will not be counted for the permanent residence permit if you don't do it continuously. So there is challenges with that. So it's mainly like to come to be here a little bit and then go back to your country. And due to COVID, due to Corona situation, actually Norwegian government introduced additional requirements or restrictions on seasonal workers. So now there is a specific list of countries that you can see here, are those countries which you will not get a seasonal work visa to enter the country. And the reason is because these countries, they don't have a charter planes from Norway to their country, and it means that in case of something urgent happening with COVID, those people cannot be returned back to their countries, and that's why they will be denied entering as a seasonal workers now during COVID situation. I think it's important to understand this. And as you can see, there is a challenge. So if you want to immigrate, this is where actually we come to the second part of the video. If you want to immigrate to Norway, so what should be your strategy? What should be your immigration strategy to come to Norway? And there I want to ask you two questions, and I recommend you to pause the video and be honest with yourself and answer on them honestly. Do you want to come to Norway just because you love Norway and you dream to live in Norway, no matter what you want to be in Norway? Or actually you care about your career in the specific field and you want to build a career, and it would be nice if you can do it in Norway, but your career is more important to you? Pause the video, answer this question to yourself, and then listen what I'm saying to you. Of course, the perfect case, it is when you can come to Norway and you can still build in your career. But in many videos you can look on the playlist about jobs in Norway, I'm telling you that Norway is quite a small country and there is a limited number of open vacancies in different fields, and not all of them needs to be filled somewhere from the external places. They can be filled with the internal workforce, and therefore some of the positions, they are not realistic to be considered as work to immigrate to Norway. In this case, you need to select whether it's so important for you to move to Norway that you are ready to go to additional education and then change your career path and keep working in Norway. Or maybe it's better for you not to immigrate to Norway, but choose another country in Europe or elsewhere that actually it will be much easier for you to find a job. Just think about that. And to be more precise, even you can search for the positions, you can apply, you can wait for a long time enough or something, maybe some lucky situation comes along and you will get this job. But you need to be patient. So there is kind of possibility. First of all, you can start looking for the job and spend a lot of time and hopefully find it. It could be that you spend a lot of time and you still cannot find the job. Then maybe you need to reconsider education as an entrance to Norway. Or maybe you actually don't need to come to Norway and you need to go to some other country and do the work you want to do and appreciate your life somewhere else. So this is different strategies for immigration. I personally selected the second one. I went through the education and then I started understanding which career path I want to take. It also could be that you have education from your home country and then you just try to maybe get more connections, and then you say that, okay, I will go and study a bit more in Norway just to get more connections, and then through the connections to find a job. So in this way, you also could keep your career. You just could have a bit more than one education related to the career, or maybe to mix them a bit with some additional stuff, and then go on with that. So this is my personal feel or my personal view on this problem. I've been thinking a lot about these strategies, and I've seen many of you asking me both skilled and unskilled work, how to immigrate, and this is my generic answer to all of your requests in the comments. I hope it was useful for you. Thank you for watching until the end, and I wish you be honest with yourself and find the right path for you. Thank you. See you next time. Bye.